here. And today is Monday, November the 23rd. It is 10:57 a.m. And this is the day that the Lord has made. And let us rejoice and be glad today. And the snow stopped last night. We had a wee bit of rain, so it was a little bit slippery this morning. But it's warming up a little bit. The Lord is good, giving protection in times of trouble. That's Nahum 1, verse 7. Philippians 4, 6, and 7 reminds us not to worry about anything, instead pray about everything. Tell God what you need. Thank Him for all that He has done. And then you'll experience God's peace, which exceeds anything that we could ever understand. And God's peace will guard your hearts and your minds as you live in Christ Jesus. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you've given us another wonderful day today. We thank you, Lord, for the preempt of winter, for the snow that's on the ground. So many children had a great time building snowmen and decorating them up. And even with that bit of rain that we had, it didn't make them collapse. But we pray, Lord, that we continue to receive some good weather as well. There's so many fields that need to be harvested. Lord, we know that everything is according to your time. And we just pray that we can be in your will. Give us faith, Lord. Help us to follow the path that you've set out for us. Keep us healthy. The ones that are having difficulties with the weather, we ask that you strengthen them. Those with health issues, we ask that you strengthen them and heal them. Be with us all, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Now we know that by loving the Lord our God with all our hearts and filling ourselves with the love of God, that love will spread. Now we're instructed to love the Lord with all of our heart, all of our soul, all of our strength, and all of our mind. But on top of that, we're instructed to love our neighbor as ourselves. Deuteronomy 6, 4-6 says, "The Lord is our God. The Lord alone. And we must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your strength. And you must commit yourselves wholeheartedly to these commands." It's not just a whim, it's something that we need to do and need to want to do. John 13:35, "Your love for one another will prove to the world that you are my disciples." That's how people know if you're a believer or a Christian. What you have stored up in your heart shows in what you say and what you do. So if you keep your heart full of love, the love of the Lord, then that's what you're going to show to the world. And then maybe the fruit of the Spirit will grow in your heart and in your soul. The Holy Spirit makes that happen. Galatians 5, 22, 23 says, "The Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our lives: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control." So we always need to do a heart check. See what's in our heart. If it's love, we've got it made, because God is with us. The weather network today says that it's 4 degrees out here in Lambton Shores, and the high today is going to be 4. How about that? So we're at the high, and it's going to go down to 0 tonight. And tonight, the weather will be clear, so if you're still getting a little bit of drizzle or a little bit of snow in your area, then you're going to expect it to clear up. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not lean on your own understanding. Seek His will in all that you do, and He'll show you which path to take." That means that we have to be listening to what the Lord is saying, paying attention to those little nudges that we get. Our COVID reports for today: Lambton Shores, the cases, no new cases, still at 401. The deaths remain at 25. We can be so thankful for that, because in this area, there hasn't been any increases in deaths for several months. We do have an increase in the confirmed recovered, though. There's 359 have recovered, so the active cases of Middlesex counts. Confirmed cases 1,468. That's 17 more than yesterday. 63 deaths. That hasn't increased either. So that's good too, because the healthcare system is working. Confirmed cases recovered 1,268. So there's 137 active cases in the London Middlesex area. Ontario. There's 1,589 new cases across Ontario. Deaths are up to 3,505. The ones in the hospital is 507, 156 in ICU, 92 on ventilators. So the active cases across Ontario is 13,004. In Canada, there was 4,792 new cases. That's down 200 from what it was yesterday. Yesterday there was 4,992 new cases. The number of deaths are up to 11,455. There's 54,999 active cases across Canada. In the US, they had 137,995 new cases since yesterday. That number is down from the day before as well, because they had almost 176,000. New ones yesterday. The number of deaths are up to 262,696. Confirmed cases across the US, 4.873 million. There was 489,927 new cases across the world. There are 16.817 cases of COVID that are active across the world. We still need to work at this and not make excuses. Our scripture today, we're carrying on with Genesis 24, starting at verse 15. Remember, the servant was sent to get a wife for Isaac by Abraham, and he was sent to Abraham's family. So starting at verse 15, it says, "Before he had finished praying, he saw a young woman named Rebekah come out with a water jug on her shoulder. She was the daughter of Bethuel, who was the son of Abraham's brother Nahor, and his wife, Milcah. Rebekah was very beautiful and old enough to be married, but she was still a virgin. She went down to the spring, filled her jug, and came up again. Running over to her, the servant said, 'Please give me a little drink of water from your jug.' 'Yes, my lord,' she answered, 'have a drink.' And she quickly lowered her jug from her shoulder and gave him a drink. When she had given him a drink, she says, 'I'll draw water for your camels too, until they have had enough to drink.' So she quickly emptied her jug into the watering trough and ran back to the well to draw water for his camels. The servant watched her in silence, wondering whether or not the Lord had given him success in his mission. Then at last, when the camels had finished drinking, he took out a gold ring for her nose and two large gold bracelets for her wrists. 'Whose daughter are you?' he asked. 'And please tell me, would your father have any room to put us up for the night?' 'I am the daughter of Bethuel,' she replied. 'My grandparents are Nahor and Milcah.'" So God did answer his prayer, because his prayer was that if the girl that he spoke to would give him the drink when he asked and give water to his camels, then he would know that that was the one for his master's son. So God answers prayers. All we have to do is ask. And we're instructed to pray for all people. 1 Timothy 2, verses 1 to 6 says, "I urge you, first of all, to pray for all people. Ask God to help them. Intercede on their behalf. And give thanks for them. Pray this way for kings and all who are in authority, so that we can live peaceful and quiet lives marked by godliness and dignity. This is good and pleases God our Savior, who wants everyone to be saved and to understand the truth. There is one God and one mediator who can reconcile God to humanity." Reconcile God and humanity, not to humanity. "The man Christ Jesus, he gave his life to purchase freedom for all people." Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word today. We thank you that you do answer prayers. And we just have to ask and have faith that you will answer. You know what the need is, Lord, but you want us to to make the choice to call out to you in faith. And Lord, help us to be faithful. Help us to build our faith, to be strong in our faith, so that we know that in all things we can rely on you. Sometimes when things start to get a little bit rough, that we start to wonder what's going on and wonder who's going to be taking care of things, when we know, in fact, at all times that you are in charge, and all we have to do is call out to you, and you will hear us, and you will answer. But at the same time, it's our responsibility to live according to your will, not our will. And that's why we need to have help to build our faith. Lord, we give you all praise, glory, and honor because of who you are. And we ask, Lord, that you have compassion on us and direct us. In Jesus' name, amen. Ephesians 4:3 says, you join together with peace through the Spirit. So make every effort to continue in this way together. That means with one another. Rely on God's word in all things. It doesn't change. It's been the same since the beginning of time. There's new translations that come out to help us understand it a little more and put it into the language that we speak today. But we need to trust it. Isaiah 41:10 says, don't worry because I am with you. Don't be afraid because I am your God. I will make you strong and I will help you. I will support you with my right hand that saves you. God has a message for us at all times. Just read the Bible, read his word, pray to him, and continue to pray for each other, especially our leaders. They need our prayers because they need strength too. Treat people with kindness, with love, with compassion, with understanding. And whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God. That's 1 Corinthians 10:31. God bless each and every one of you, and may God be with you until we meet again.